بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. 2020 a year of change, or am I still on 50-50? We need to be checking ourselves all the time. The people of Iman check themselves, monitor themselves, see their progress with regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with regards to Akhirat as well. Generally, history shows that people who are not in Amal, and when conditions come, find it difficulty to resort to Amal. Many turn to sin or do Amal till the condition departs, and then they carry on a normal life. Likewise, as a believer, we should not be oblivious of what's happening. In every condition, our heart, our attention, our focus will go to on ourselves and our amal, but at the same time, we are not oblivious. The Qiyamah series we did about chemtrails, curfew hours, the darkness of the night, suddenly planes are spraying pesticides, the movement of military vehicles, the impossibility of a virus to evolve, literally dying down and suddenly to spring up in peak summer. So a believer is not gullible as well. لا يلدخ المؤمن من جحر واحد مرتين. That we are not bitten by the same hole twice. Likewise, اتقوا فراسة المؤمن. Beware of the foresight. Behold the foresight and the vision of a believer. This is very special. Allah has given every person of Iman this foresight. Nevertheless, we need to take stock of ourselves, and after witnessing mini qiyamah, small qiyamah, we need to see how much have I changed, how much has my ta'aluk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increased. And qiyamah it will be nafsi, nafsi, yawma yafirru al-mar'u min akhi wa ummihi wa abihi. A person will be only worried about themselves. They will run away from their family members. Likewise, people will be abstaining, staying far away from their beloved ones. Likewise, panic buying, shelves emptied, possibility of no provisions. Likewise, lockdown made people a prisoner who were free. لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنُ يُغْنِي. That put people in a frenzy. People are seeing their beloveds, their loved ones dying in front of them, departing from this dunya, knowing you cannot do anything about it. And seeing and witnessing sickness with no cure, poverty with no wealth, darkness without light. So these are all signs for a believer, and we need to see that we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all these conditions. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi used to say, مُصِيبَةٌ تُقْبَلُ بِهَا عَلَى اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُنْسِيكَ ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ. A calamity that makes you turn to Allah is better for you than a blessing which makes you forget the remembrance of Allah. A calamity that makes you turn to Allah is better for you than a blessing which makes you forget the remembrance of Allah. So this condition, this hal, this situation needs to take a person closer to Allah. It should propel one towards Allah. Sufyan bin Uyayna rahmatullahi alayhi used to say, مَا يَكْرَهُ الْعَبْدُ خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِمَّا يُحِبُّ. What a person dislikes may be better for him than what he likes. لِأَنَّ مَا يَكْرَهُهُ يَهِيجُهُ عَلَى الدُّعَاءِ وَمَا يُحِبُّ يُلْهِيهِ عَنْهُ. Because whatever he dislikes causes him to call upon Allah. That difficulty, that hardship turns a person towards Allah. Whereas what he likes may make him heedless. A person likes something and he prefers something, but that preference will take him away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Qayyim said it once. Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi said to him, this is when he was imprisoned, and he considered a blessing which his enemies had done a favor on him. He was imprisoned and he considered it a blessing from his enemies. And he said, Ma yasna wa da'i bi, that what can my enemies do to me? My garden is my heart. In ruhtu fahiya ma'i, wherever I go with me, it never leaves me. In habsi khalwa, my detainment is seclusion, meaning it's an opportunity to worship Allah. Wa qatli shahada, and my being killed is martyrdom. Wa ikhraji min baladi siyaha, and my being expelled from my city, from my hometown, is a journey, it's just another travel. And while he was in detainment in the fortress, in the prison, he used to say, لَوْ بَذَلْتُ مِلْأَ هَذِهِ الْقَلْعَ ذَهَبًا, if I were to spend and fill this fortress in gold, مَا عَدَلَ عِنْدِي شُكْرَ هَذِي النِّعْمَةِ, it would not be sufficient to express my gratitude for this blessing which Allah has favored me. He is in prison, apparently he is suffering, yet he is saying that he cannot express the gratitude of Allah. And he used to say, مَا جَزَيْتُهُمْ عَلَى مَا تَسَبَّبُوا لِي فِيهِ مِنَ الْخَيْرِ, I would not be able to sufficiently reward the enemy for what goodness they brought to me if I filled the entire premises with gold. And he used to read as well, Allahumma inni ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa usni ibadatik. O Allah, help me remember you, give thanks to you, and to worship you well. So when a person is in halat, when there is in difficulties, conditions, when there is hopelessness, we should lose the hopeless and have less hope in the things of the world and have more hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here is a great scholar of deen, but he considered that condition a bounty and a ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So likewise, a person is afflicted with a plague, with a sickness, considered a bounty of Allah. Ibn al-Qayyim rahmatullah alayhi in Zadul Ma'ad has mentioned 9 things to consider when difficulties occur. أَيَنْذُرُ إِلَى مَا أُسِيبَ بِهِ, that a person should look at what has befallen him, and you will find that Allah has left for him more better than he can imagine if he is patient and if he accepts it. Allah has kept in store for him multifold. So through the loss of this difficulty, through this calamity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him something far greater. Number 2, أَيُّدْفِعَ نَارَ مُصِيبَتِهِ, the fire of calamity can be extinguished by thinking of those who have been hit even harder. So he should look around, see what difficulties other people around him are going through, and he will realize that his difficulty is light. وَإِنَّ الشُّرُورَ الدُّنْيَا أَحْلَامُ نَوْمٍ, and the pains of this world are like the dreams, or like a passing shadow, or like a person who smiles, but his smiling is less. أَبْكَتْ كَثِيرًا, so if you are happy for a day, then remember, you won't be miserable for a lifetime. Dunya is like that. You may be happy for a day, but a person is miserable for a lifetime. And if you have what you want for a little bit while, you will be deprived for a long time. So there is no day of happiness followed by a day of pain. The dunya is made of that. It is a constituent factor of dunya, of a combination of difficulties and hardships. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu used to say, مَعَ كُلِّ فَرْحَةٍ تَرْحَى, for every moment of joy there is a moment of grief and sorrow. وما ملئ بيت حبرة إلا ملئ عبرة. And no house is filled with joy, but it will be filled with sorrow. It will be filled with sorrow. So that's the dunya. There'll always be good conditions and difficulties. Muhammad ibn Sirin used to say, ما كان ضحك قط إلا كان من بعده بكاء. There is never any laughter, but there comes weeping after it. So there'll be days of happiness, there'll be days of sadness. Number three, أن يعلم أن فوات ثواب الصبر. That he should know that panicking will not make the calamity go away, but it will make the situation worse. Panicking will not make the problem go away, but it will make the situation worse. Number four, that must sit out on reward for patience, which is a mercy of Allah, is a worse and more detrimental than the calamity. So a person is befallen with some difficulty, is befallen with some hardship, and says Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun, and is patient, he is losing out more in being patient, and it's worse than the calamity itself. Then number five, a ya'lam anna al-jaza', it should be noted that panicking, anxiety, uneasiness makes one enemy rejoice and makes one's friend feel sad, makes Allah angry, makes shaitan happy, it destroys rewards, it weakens the resolute. But this person is patient, seeks rewards in Allah, strives to please Allah, then Allah will make his friend happy, his enemy sad, and shaitan will become more unhappy. So a person should be steadfast and should not react and be contented with the decree of Allah. Number six, he should know فَلْيَنْذُرْ أَيَّ مُصِيبَتَيْنْ عَذَمْ. So after being patient and seeking reward, then a person should know that Allah is building him palaces in Jannah. So he should decide which of the two calamities is greater, the calamity of this world or missing out on the bounties in Akhirat. On the day of Qiyamah, the people who went through no difficulties, يَوَدُّ أَهْلُ الْعَافِيَةِ أَنَّ جُلُودَهُمْ, they will wish that their skins be cut with scissors in this world. They will wish their bodies were shredded into pieces when they will see the reward of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives those people who went through all the difficulties and hardships. Like it is said, لَوْلَا مَصَائِبُ, if it was not for the calamities of this world, we would have come empty-handed on the day of Qiyamah. We would have come empty-handed on the day of Qiyamah. Number seven, أَيَّعْلَمْ أَنَّ الَّذِي ابْتَلَاهُ بِهَا, you should know that the one who has put him in this condition is أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ, is the most wise, the most merciful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send the calamity to destroy him, cause him pain, finish him off. But Allah is checking on him, testing his patience, accepting him. And Allah wants to hear this banda making dua, turning to Allah, standing before Allah, seeking protection from Allah, and becoming more humble. Number eight, he should understand that if it were not for trials and tribulations in this world, a person would develop arrogance, self-admiration, and a satanic, a pharaonic attitude. So, like the poet says, يُنْعِمُ اللَّهُ بِالْبَلْوَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses us with calamities, even if that is difficult and hard. وَيَبْتَلِي, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests some people with blessings. So some people are tested with blessings, other people are tested with difficulties. So this is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect him from other evils. And the last one he said, أَيَّعْلَمْ أَنَّ مِرَارَ الدُّنْيَا هِيَ بِعَيْنِهَا حَلَاوَةُ الْآخِرَةِ. You should note that the bitterness of this world is the sweetness of the hereafter. Is Allah will change it. Likewise, the sweetness of this world is the bitterness of the hereafter. So it is rather better to move from temporary bitterness to eternal sweetness than from sweetness to eternal bitterness. So a person, we know dunya is filled with difficulties and hardships, and we will be tested and we will go through many trials and tribulations. A believer knows Allah is watching, and when he gets yaqeen that Allah is watching, then progress will start and his taluk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase. So we have to have the diyan and the awareness that Allah is watching me, Allah knows my action, and I am accountable for every movement. They said there was a youngster and a father, and this boy was very physically weak and small in size, but the father encouraged him. He wanted to play football, so he said, you can go play football. So he used to go be by the games, and in school as well he tried out, he was part of the team, but he never played. Years passed like this. Then he went to college, again he tried to be part of the team. Everybody was sure this kid's not gonna make it, but the coach for some reason kept him on. So it so happened that this boy here used to encourage them and give the team good spirit, and the coach liked it. And one day he gave them encouragement and they won. He phoned his father, he gave him the good news. And all this time the father used to be there present in every match, and the boy never missed any training session, any match, and he was there always. So it was end of the season and it was the last final match, and they got a message and the boy was in depression. And the coach asked him, what's wrong? He said, my father passed away this morning. Is it fine if I must practice today for the big game? So the coach said, no problem, take the rest of the week off. If you don't want to come for the game as well, don't come for it. So the young boy was there for the game. So it so happened that the team was losing and the boy was waiting, and then eventually he decided he's going to walk away. And as he walked away, he reached the locker room and said, no, I need to play. So he went to the coach and begged the coach, let me play. The coach said, no, this is the worst time ever. But he persisted. Because his father passed away, the coach felt him sorry. So his boy went onto the stadium. They say he played like a superstar. The team began to win. The scores were tied. And at the end, he scored a touchdown. And they won the tournament. So after everybody left and the stands were emptied, the coach was alone with this youngster. And he said, I can't believe it. You are fantastic. You are phenomenal. Tell me what got into you. How did you do it? So he looked at the coach with tears in his eyes and he said, well, you knew my dad had passed away, but what you don't know is he was blind. What you don't know is that he was blind. And with difficulty and tears in his eyes, he said that my father came to all the games and he could not see me play. This was the first game that he was seeing me, and I wanted to show him I could do it. I wanted to show him I could do it. This is the attention of the makhluk, the creation, towards the creation. Imagine if we had the ihsas and the dhyan and the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How would we have played the game of dunya? How would we have played this game of dunya? The amal for today is akhlis deenaka yakfika al-amalul qaleel. Purify deen. Little bit amount of amal will suffice. Innama tunsaru hadhihi al-umma bi dha'ifiha. This ummah has been helped and assisted by the weak, by their supplications, their salah and ikhlas. Tuba lil mukhlisin. Glad tidings to the sincere ones. Ulaika masabihul huda. They are the lights of guidance. Tanjali anhum kullu fitna dhalma. Every dark tribulation is dispelled by them. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.